The Gallantry Awards Portal organized an innovative Greyhound tribute competition in which participants from all over India were invited to recommend unique and innovative tributes to salute the brave hearts of the nation. The objective of the competition is to find a series of befitting tribute messages for the Gallantry Awardees. The competition to be held from 15th April to 15th May 2021. Gallantry Awards were given to defense personnel for their remarkable services. And awards were categorized as Paramveer Chakra, Ashok Chakra, Mahavir Chakra, Kirti Chakra, Veer Chakra and Shaurya Chakra. Paramveer Chakra is India's highest military decoration awarded for displaying distinguished act of valor during wartime. Ashok Chakra is India's highest peacetime military decoration awarded for valor, courage, action or self-sacrifice away from the battlefield. It is equivalent to the Paramveer Chakra and it awarded either to military or civilian personnel.
Union Minister of State for Tourism and Culture, Prahlad Singh Patel addressed a webinar, India's Heritage Powering Tourism, organized by the Ministry of Tourism on the occasion of the World Heritage Day 2021. He's also inaugurated the online exhibition on Ramayana, the epic by Maharshi Valmiki, which is the very first online exhibition on the Ramayana. The theme of World Heritage Day 2021 is Complex Past, Diverse Features. Piyush Goyal, Cabinet Minister of the Government of India, having portfolios such as Minister of Railways, Minister of Commerce and Industry, and Minister of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, he launched the Startup India Seed Fund Scheme, SISFS. The fund aims to provide financial assistance to startups for proof of concept, prototype development, product trials, market entry, and commercialization. SISFS, announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 16th January 2021 in his grand plenary address of Praram, Startup India International Summit, making the 5 years anniversary of the Startup India initiative. Corpus amount of 945 crore rupees to be delivered over the next 4 years for providing seed funding to eligible startups through eligible incubators across. This scheme expected to support an estimated 3,600 startups through 300 incubators. Indian Naval Air Squadron, INAS 323, the first unit of the indigenously built ALH MK3 aircraft commissioned into the Indian Navy in the presence of Minister of State for Defense Sripad Naik and Vice Admiral R. Harikumar at INS Hansa Goa on 19th April 2021. ALH MK3, a multi-role helicopter with a Shakti engine manufactured by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. It is an all-glass cockpit and used for search and rescue, special operations and coastal surveillance. 16 MK3 aircraft were under procurement and aircraft to be delivered in a phased manner to the Indian Navy. INAS 323 is commanded by Commander Samayak Nandi. The Center for Land Warfare Studies, CLAWS, an autonomous think tank under the Indian Army, established a joint initiative with Manipal Academy of Higher Education, Mangalore, formerly known as Manipal University, to conduct PhD programs for Army officers. CLAWS class taken an initiative to further enhance the professional military education of officers. Class recognized as a sub-center of Manipal Academy of Higher Education, by virtue of which 5 class faculties will serve as co-supervisors. Class will also initiate the selection process and conduct mandatory research methodology classes as per guidelines given by the UGC and MAHE Mangalore. The Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs and Dutch Gesellschaft für internationale Zusammenarbeit, GmbH India, on behalf of the German Federal Ministry of Environment, Nature Conservation and Nuclear Safety, signed an agreement on technical cooperation titled Cities Combating Plastic Entering the Marine Environment in New Delhi. This project is envisaged under the contours of the Joint Declaration of Intent regarding cooperation in the field of prevention of marine litter. signed between India and Germany in 2019. The project aimed at enhancing practices to prevent plastic from entering the marine environment will be undertaken at the national level. The selected states, Uttar Pradesh, Kerala and Andaman Nicobar Islands, and in the cities of Kanpur, Kochi and Port Blair for a period of 3.5 years. It is estimated that 15-20% of all plastics are entering oceans via riverine ecosystems, of which 90% are contributed by 10 of the world's most polluting rivers. Two of these river systems are located in India, Ganga and Brahmaputra. First oxygen express rigs left from Mumbai to Vizag to take oxygen. Indian Railways scaled up to run oxygen express in response to growing COVID-19. Mumbai division built a ramp overnight within 24 hours at Kalamboli Goods Yard to facilitate loading and unloading of tankers in or from flat wagons. The Ro-Ro service with several empty tankers departed from Kalamboli Goods Yard to the Visakhapatnam steel plant. The Ministry of Tourism organized the 85th webinar titled Khajuraho Temples of Architectural Splendor in the Dekho Apna Desh webinar series. Dekho Apna Desh webinar series is an effort to showcase India's rich diversity under Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat. Khajuraho temples were built between 950 AD to 1050 AD by the Chandela dynasty. The Union Cabinet has given its ex post facto approval to the MOU between the Director General of Trade Remedies, India and Bangladesh. Trade and Tariff Commission Bangladesh on the establishment of a framework of cooperation in the area of trade remedial measures signed on 27th March 2021 at Dhaka. The main objective of the MOU is to promote cooperation between the two countries in the area of trade remedies, covering the broad activities related to exchange of information, undertaking capacity building activities, and activities in accordance with the various provisions of the World Trade Organization in the area of anti-dumping, countervailing, and safeguard measures in bilateral trade between India and Bangladesh. The Union Cabinet approved the MOU between the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India (ICAI) and Chartered Accountants Australia and New Zealand (CAANZ). The ICAI and CAANZ aim to establish a mutual cooperation framework for the advancement of accounting knowledge, professional and intellectual development, advancement of the interest of their respective members, and contribute positively to the development of the accounting profession in Australia, New Zealand, and India. ICAI is a statutory body established by an Act of Parliament of India, the Chartered Accountants Act 1949, to regulate the profession of chartered accountants in India. CAANZ emerged from the merger of the Institute of Chartered Accountants in Australia and the New Zealand Institute of Chartered Accountants in October 2014. The Cabinet approved the Mutual Recognition Agreement (MRA) between the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India (ICAI) and the CPA Australia (Certified Practicing Accountants Australia). Under the agreement, both will work together to establish a mutual cooperation framework for the advancement of accounting knowledge, professional and intellectual development, advancement of the interest of their respective members, and contribute positively to the development of the accounting profession in Australia and India. CPA Australia is one of the world's largest accounting bodies, with a membership of more than 160,000 members working in 150 countries and regions around the world, and offers services in education, training, technical support, and advocacy.